Welcome everyone, welcome to my channel Marine Sea Time. Today I will be discussing about the planned maintenance program on auxiliary engine onships. So you can see over here this dot circle will be overhauled to be carried out, and this square dot square one will be check the condition. So time between overhaul is 50 hours, 200 hours, 2000, 6000 hours, 12000 hours, 24000. So one by one we will be discussing about what are all the major overhaul and what are the inspection we will do on the auxiliary engine on ships. So cylinder unit. So it's in the cylinder unit, dismantling of the cylinder unit, dismantling of cylinder head, water jacket and cylinder liner. It is done at every 12000 running hours of the engine. Now cylinder head, water jacket, inspection of inlet exhaust valve and valve grid. This is done at 12000 hours. Valve rotator, we only check the condition of valve rotators, lubrication of operating gears, cylinder head cooling water space inspection, cylinder head nut re-tightening. It is done at every 12000 hours. Then piston connecting rod and cylinder liner. Inspection of piston 12000 hours. Piston rings and scraper ring 12000 hours. Then piston pin and bows for connecting rod. Check of clearance 12000 hours. Connecting rod measuring of big end bore 12000 hours. Inspection of big end bearing cells 12000 hours. Then connecting rod retightening. Connecting rod retightening is done at 6000 hours. Then cylinder liner cleaning, honing and measuring 12000 hours. Then we will come to the camshaft and the camshaft drive. Camshaft inspection of gear wheels, bolt, connection, etc. at 200 hours. Camshaft bearing inspection of clearance 12000 hours. Camshaft adjustment, check the condition 12000 hours. Lubrication of the camshaft bearing, check 12000 hours. Now operating gear for inlet valve and exhaust valve, roller guide for valve gear, valve bridge, spring, push rod, etc. 12000 hours. Lubricating of the operating gear, check 12000 hours. Camshaft and main bearing. And then we will come at camshaft and main bearing. So inspection of main bearing and the inspection of guide bearing is done at every 24000 hours. Then main and guide bearing cap retightening. Main and guide bearing cap retightening is done at 6000 hours. Counterweight is added into the main bearing at 6000 hours. Now engine frame and base frame. Bolt between engine frame and base frame retightening 6000 hours. Turbocharger system. So turbocharger system is inspected at this observation should be done. Charging air cooler cleaning and inspection, retightening of all bolts and connection, cleaning of the compressor when dismounted, cleaning of the silencer when dismounted, basic check all component bearing, etc. So this is done at the observation at every This is done at the observation time. Compressed air system, air starter motor dismantling and inspection. Now if this two, turbocharger system and the compressed air system, fails only, then only we will do all this cleaning and inspection, or if any observation is there that we have to do cleaning of this turbocharger system and the compressed air system, then only we will dismantle and inspect all this. Now fuel oil system and injection piping. Fuel oil injection valve is done at every 2000 hours. Lubricating oil pump engine driven is done at 12,000 hours and pre-lubricating pump is done at 12,000 hours. And lube oil cooler and thermostatic valve is done at the observation. Now if there is any problem in the lube oil cooler, if the temperature inlet and outlet is swinging very less, that means the lube oil cooler is choked, then only we will overhaul this lube oil cooler and thermostatic valve. Thermostatic valve is to maintain the temperature of the LT water and the HT water. So if there is any fluctuation in this, then only we will overhaul this thermostatic valve. Now cooling water system, cooling water pump, engine driven, HT and LT pump. So this is mostly done on the 12,000 hours. But now suppose if there is any variation in the, then we have to overhaul it. If we have a suspect that this cooling water pump of the HT and LT is worn out or it is damaged, then only we will do the overhauling and inspection of the cooling water pump. Now guys, this is all about the overhauling, inspection and the planned maintenance program which we do in the auxiliary engine also. Hope you all guys understood the video. If you liked the video, please like and share, and if you haven't subscribed till now, please subscribe the channel to get more videos like this. Thank you. God bless you.